Let's do some math for fun, and this time we'll do some trick questions. We are going to evaluate cosine of 20 degrees times cosine of 40 degrees times cosine of 80 degrees. Of course, we're not going to use a calculator, otherwise you will defeat this great question, right? And it seems like this question is well designed, otherwise nobody can do it, right? I don't think if you just want me to do cosine of 20 degrees, I will be able to figure out what that value is. I don't think that's a nice number in terms of radical or in terms of decimal, whatnot, right? But all these three things, is there any connection? Yeah, because we see that 20 degrees, 40 degrees, and 80 degrees, just double, right? Maybe we should look at the double angle formula, and let's talk about it right here on the side.
First of all, we know the double angle formula for cosine, so let me write it down, cosine of 2 theta. This right here, we have three versions of it, and let me just write down the first version, which is cosine squared theta minus sine squared theta.
But this is not good, because, yes, I am dealing with cosine. However, if you look at the right-hand side, we are working with squares. That's not good. Let me avoid that.
But we also have another double angle formula, and that's for sine. Let's look at sine of 2 theta. We know this is going to be 2 sine theta times cosine theta.
But in here, we don't care about sine, right? We care about cosine. It's okay. Let's divide both sides by 2 sine theta. In another word, we can look at this equation here, and we can say this is the same as cosine theta equals to sine 2 theta on the top over 2 sine theta, like this. And I think I would like to use this one instead. I will change all the cosines into the sines right here, and let's see what happens. So, for example, for the first one, theta is going to be the 20 degrees right here. And in terms of the sine, this is what we're going to get. So, I will plug in 20 degrees into the theta here. On the top, we will have sine of 2 times 20 degrees. That will be 40 degrees. So this is going to be sine of 40 degrees, right? And then we divide it by 2 sine. And once again, the theta is 20 degrees, like this. And we multiply by next. Here, the angle is 40 degrees, and we plug into here and here, right? So that means we have sine of 2 times 40, which is 80 degrees, over 2 sine of this angle, which is 40 degrees. You see already, huh? Because this and that cancel out. That's very nice, right? And let's look at the third one. And here we have angle theta is equal to 80 degrees, plug into here and here. So we will have sine of 160 degrees, 80 times 2, right? So that's 160 degrees, over 2 times sine of 80 degrees, like this. What's happening is, this and that cancel out, this and that cancel out. So nice, right? I didn't even know what's sine of 40 degrees, but it's okay because it doesn't matter anymore. And let's see, altogether, what do we have? On the top, we have sine of 160 degrees over, on the bottom, we have 2 times 2 times 2, which is going to be an 8. And then this right here still survives. Oh my God, sine of 20 degrees. And now what? What's this compared to that? Look at, this is 160 degrees and this is 20 degrees. They add up to be 180, right? And in fact, they are the same. And there's an identity. I would like to put it down for you guys. Whenever you have sine of theta, if this, right, the other angle, when you add this and that, if the angle is able to be 180, it's actually the same value. Sine theta is the same as saying sine of 180 degrees minus whichever that angle was. And this is also another identity we have to use. So, you can look at this right here is the theta, which is 160 degrees, right? And let me write this down. You know this right here, it will be the same as sine of 180 degrees minus 160 degrees, which is 20 degrees. So altogether, on the top is sine of also 20 degrees over 8 sine of 20 degrees. Cancel out, of course. Final answer. 1 over 8 without a calculator. Cool, huh?
Black pen.